Across the Americas and around the world, once again you're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm your host, William Cooper, and in studio
is Carolyn Nelson.
Folks, I'm going to be on a little investigative trip here for the next week, and while I'm going, you're going to hear reruns on both time slots. Those of you listening now have probably never heard these episodes of the Hour of the Time, and you should always listen to this broadcast with a pad of paper and a pencil or pen by your side. Never, ever make the mistake of sitting down without a pad of paper and a pen or pencil to listen to the Hour of the Time. We have very short patience around here for people who do not follow directions. So if you call up and want us to recount the show for you because you didn't have your pad of paper and your pencil, I'm sorry, we don't have time to do that. We're very, very busy here. So make sure you get it the first time. If you miss a telephone number because we only say it once, that's okay. Now, I want you all to remember and try to catch both broadcasts each day, simply because they're not the same, ever. What's broadcast in this time slot, 5 p.m. Pacific, 6 Mountain, 7 Central, and 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, is not the same information that is broadcast during the later time slot, which is 9 Pacific, 10 Mountain, 11 Central, and midnight Eastern Standard Time. Tonight's show is important, for it verifies everything that I've been telling you in the Mystery Babylon series, which we have done 31 episodes of, and we have included The Dawn of Man, which ran prior to the production of the Mystery Babylon series, in any orders for this series. So that actually makes 32 tapes, but tonight's episode will be episode number 32 of the series known as Mystery Babylon. Don't go away, folks. You need to know what you're going to hear tonight.
Don't believe the devil. I don't believe it, but the truth is not the same without the lies he made up. Don't believe in excess. Success is to give. Don't believe in riches, but you should see where I live. I believe in love. Don't believe in forces. Don't believe in rage. But every time she passes by, wild horses stay. Don't believe in death row, speed row of hands. Don't believe in the Uzi, just went off in my hand.
For those of you who don't believe that those who call themselves illumined, the only truly mature minds in this world, and thus are the only ones capable of deciding the future or of ruling the rest of us, those of you who don't believe these people have infiltrated all levels of our society, our government, our military, our law enforcement, I want you to listen carefully to what I'm going to read you. I'm going to quote verbatim an article which appeared in the newsletter called Aid and Abet Police Newsletter, Volume 2, Constitutional Issues for Lawmen, Number 1, Volume 2, Number 1. That's Aid and Abet Police Newsletter. Now, this letter, according to the editor of this newsletter was written by a police chief. Here he uses a pseudonym, so he says, so that the police chief's identity is not revealed. However, as you will find out if you have listened to our series on Mystery Babylon, this is not just a police chief. This is a highly degreed member of the Masonic Lodge. And he gives himself away with his symbology. For at the end of his article, he signs it, quote, "So mote it be," unquote. Aid and abet is put out by Officer Jack McLam, who has been written up as one of the best police officers ever produced by the state of Arizona. We neither endorse him, nor do we condemn him. As far as CAGI is concerned, our vote is not in yet on this organization. We know that in order to bring about the New World Order, they need to identify everyone who will uphold the real law, the Constitution, the supreme law of the land. They need to identify those people and get them out of positions of authority, and if necessary, take them out of society completely. There are organizations which exist solely for the purpose of identifying those people in government, those people in the patriot community, those police officers serving in police organizations who would ultimately support the Constitution and the Bill of Rights against any effort to destroy it. Aid and abet may be one of these means. We do not know that for certain. But if you listen to this letter, because it's signed with a pseudonym, may not be from a police chief at all, but may be from those who control aid and abet to tell the police officers what is expected of them in the New World Order. Again, we do not know this to be true, but we have discovered, ladies and gentlemen, in our investigations, that those who oppose us, who would destroy us, use the Hegelian dialectic of political conflict resolution. They control both sides of every issue. They set in motion methods and means to identify their enemy and destroy their enemy before their enemy can hurt them. And that's why we have been on the losing end for literally thousands of years with these people. I now quote from this newsletter. To the question of, do some judges, prosecutors, and police officers today commit dishonest acts to put criminals away? I answer an unequivocal yes. But it is hoped that it is not done without just cause. True immorality exists only when the cause is not just. Notice how they've turned the definition of morality around. And he goes on, after more than 20 years of service to my fellow Americans, I realize what reality is. The truth is that today many judges, attorneys, police officials, and officers are devotees.